Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can download and install the toolset for C and C++ so that we can write and execute C and C++ programs in Windows 11 operating system. We will also see how we can download and install a debugger for debugging the C and C++ programs. So the first thing that we do is we will open up any browser that is installed in the computer. I have Microsoft Edge. I'm gonna open it up. And here in the URL bar, we will enter msys2.org. This MSYS2 is a software distribution and building platform for Windows. By using this, we can download and install latest version of GCC, that is GNU Compiler Collection, in our computer. GCC provides the tool chain or tool sets for the programming languages like C, C++, Ada, Fortran, etc. And also GCC provides a debugger. The first thing that we have to do is we have to download and install this MSYS2. And in this installation section, we can see download the installer. Click on the link here. It will download the installer. Don't read into the version number here. Depending on when you're watching this video, it will be different. And this tutorial will be applicable for all the future versions also. So we will click on this. It will download the MSYS2. We just have to wait for the download to finish. Okay, now the download is complete. If I take the cursor on this downloaded file, then I can see this folder icon which says show in folder. If I click on that, it will open up the folder where the downloaded files are saved. As you guys can see here, we have downloaded this MSYS2 installation file. So what we have to do is we have to double click on this file and we have to install MSYS2. So here it says welcome and we will click on next. We will not change the path here. We will click on next. We will not do anything. We will click on next. It will install MSYS2. We will wait for the installation to finish. Now by using the magic of video editing, I will fast forward this. It will take some time to install in your computer. So just wait for the installation to finish. Okay, now the installation is complete. We will check this checkbox which says run MSYS2 now. And then we will click on finish. It will open up the command window. Now the first thing that we do is we will make sure that all the packages are updated. So we will type in a command which is pacman space minus capital S and then lowercase yu. I will provide these commands in the description box, you don't have to worry. And after that hit the enter button. It will check for the packages and it will update them if any updates are available. Now in my case, updates are available and that's why it says proceed with the installation. In your case, updates may be available or may not be available. If the updates are not available, then it will say there is nothing to do. But if the updates are available, then enter Y and hit the enter button. It will download and install the updates. If updates are not available, then you don't have to worry. You can continue with the next command. Now here, to complete the updates, terminal will be closed. So in order to confirm that, we will enter Y and hit the enter button. Now the terminal window has been closed. Now we will click on the start button and we will search for MSYS. And here we can see some apps, MSYS2, MSYS, and also we can see MSYS2, UCRT64. We can choose any of this. I will choose MSYS2, MSYS. Once I click on that, it will open up the terminal window. Now again, we will make sure that everything is up to date. So here I will enter pacman space minus capital S yu and hit the enter button. Now there are some updates available. So again, it asks for proceed with installation. We will enter Y and hit the enter button. In your case, updates may not be available. In that case, it will say nothing to update. You can continue with the next command. But updates are available, then we will make sure that we install them. Okay, now the updates are done. Now again, we will check for any updates. So I will type in pacman minus capital S YU and hit the enter button. And this time it will say no updates available because we just have already updated everything. So now you guys can see if updates are not available, then you will see this kind of message. You don't have to worry about it. You can continue with the next command. So now what we can do is we can install the toolset for C and C++ programming language. Now here we have to enter a command. I will provide this command in the description box. You guys can copy from there, or you can watch this video and again copy the command. So here I'm gonna copy and paste the command, so which is nothing but pacman minus s and then minus minus needed. We will install base-devel and MinGW UCRT toolchain. So this will install the MinGW toolchain for all the languages like C, C++, Ada, Fortran, all the packages will be installed. So if I hit the enter button here, it will display the packages that it will install. For example, we can see it will install the GCC package for C, C++, for Ada, for Fortran. It will also install a debugger, all the required libraries. So here we will install everything. And to do that, it says default equal to all. So we can directly just hit the enter button. Now it will display all the libraries that it will install. We just have to enter Y and hit the enter button. It will download all those packages and install them. We just have to sit back and wait for the installation to finish. Okay, now the installation is complete. The last thing that we do is we will check for any updates. So we will enter pacman space minus capital S YU and hit the enter button. It will check for the updates. And if any updates are available, then it will show. But at this particular time, no updates are available. So now what we can do is we can close this terminal. So what we have done now is we have downloaded and installed the toolset for C and C++. The next thing that we have to do is we have to update the path enrollment variable in Windows 11 operating system so that we can access this C and C++ toolset from any folder in the file system. To do that, we will open up the folder where the C and C++ toolset are installed. So in my case, it will be C drive and in the MSYS64 folder. So I'm gonna open it up. And here we can see many different folders. In this, we will go to UCRT64. In this particular folder, we will open it up. And here we will open up the bin folder. So now here you can see all the programs that we have installed. For example, GCC, G++, and GDB, all these programs are installed here. So what we have to do is we have to copy the path of this particular location. To do that, we just go to this address bar section, which is at the top, and we will click it here. Just left click. It will highlight the path and we will right click and then copy this path. Okay. After that, we can minimize this folder. And now we will click on the start button and we will search for edit environment variables. And we can see control panel, edit environment variables for your account. We will click on that. It will open up this particular window. Here we can find the user variables and system variables. In the user variables section, we can see path. We will click on it and it will be highlighted like this. Then we will click on edit. And here we will click on new. And then we will paste the path that we have copied, which is C, then MSYS64. UCRT64 and then the bin folder. We will click outside, we will click on OK, and then we will click on OK. So now we have updated the path. Now we will see whether GCC, G++ are accessible from any folder in the file system. To check that, we will click on the start button and we will search for CMD. We will open up the command prompt And here we will type in GCC space minus minus version. We are trying to find the version of GCC installed. If I hit the enter button here, then you can see here it says GCC 13.2.0 is installed. In your case, this version number may be different depending on when you're watching this video. Now again, we will type in G++ space minus minus version and we will hit the enter button and we can see the version number here. Similarly, we will check the version number for GDB, that is the debugger. So we will type in GDB space minus minus version and we will hit the enter button and we can see the version of GDB installed in the computer. So this is it guys. This is how we can download and install latest version of C and C++ toolset from GCC in Windows 11 operating system. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. While doing the installation, if you face any issues, then post your issue in the comment section. I'll try to help. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next one.